Good.
Hey, Hannah. Hey, Jasmine. Thank you for joining us. Community Bridges, new. Glad you're on the team. Okay, please keep both hands on the wheel, Jasmine. Buddy, one thing that I really do need. Oh, everybody, Caitlin Putnam just joined us. What? Caitlin, thank you for joining us. Drop your name, your organization in the chat, and also we want to know who's in the room. So if you are a program director, an executive director, or a staff person or a mentor, please put that in the chat. And we're going to get started in about 3 more minutes. Once again, thank everyone for joining. Tracy, thanks for joining us. Your name. Naisha, thanks for joining us. Hey, Joe, thanks for joining us. This is our pre-national mentoring month. So you put the emphasis on pre-national mentoring month social. The surveys come up later. Hey, thank y'all for joining us. Welcome. If you could put your program and your name in the chat, your organization and your name in the chat, and we want to know who's in the room. So if you're a mentor or if you're a program staff or program director, executive director, please put that. We want to know who's in the room. Thank you. Thank you. If you can open up the chat. But if you're driving, Jasmine, don't do it. Is that Carl Scott? What? Best kids in the house. Hey, best kids. Hey, Carl, if you could do us a favor, not everybody is as enamored with you as I am. If you could do me a favor, put your name and your org in the chat and what role you hold with best kids, that would be awesome. Is that Diamond? Hey, Diamond. Good to see you. With your 149 mentors. Oh my goodness. Diamond, we're excited that you're on the call with all. I know you've got so many balls juggling. Thank you for joining us. Yep. Everybody, put your name in the chat and your organization. We're at 12:03. We're going to kick off at 12:05. Thank you so much for joining us. Victoria, thank you. Yolanda, thank you. I could be just as good if you check off my. And let's see. Very good. Very good. Thank you for joining us. Everybody, see, hey, everybody, we are full staff today. Well, a couple of our staff members aren't here, but we're full staff with Mentor Maryland DC. I'm excited. You're going to get to see some new faces. So very excited about this year's social. Thank you for joining us. This is our pre-national mentoring month social. Know that you guys have great things in store for your programs for the month of January. And just glad that you're on the call. Once again, last call, put your name, your organization in the chat, and your role with your organization. Just want to find out who's in the room. Once again, thank you so much for joining us. Sign your X on the right. Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney. Very good. Very good. All right. If you're ready to begin, everybody, give me a thumbs up. Ready to get started? Give me a thumbs up. Good. Good. Ah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for that smile. All right. And once again, if you haven't done so already, go ahead and share your name, your organization, put your pronouns. Thank you for that thumbs up, Tracy. Thanks, Joe. Thanks, Claire. And put your name, your organization, and your pronouns in the chat. And we are going to kick off. I want to share this next slide with you. Mentoring is for everyone. One thing that you're going to hear from Mentor Maryland DC over the next year, 2024, as we really shift the narrative, we're going to be emphasizing, and we ask that you would do the same, this concept that mentoring is for everyone. It's not just for one specific demographic. It's for lottie-dottie, everybody, as my grandmom used to say. I'm going to kick it off to my good colleague, Rebecca. She's going to go over our agenda, and then we'll jump into introductions. Hey, Rebecca.
Hello, and I will reiterate that welcome. We really are appreciative and excited that you all are here today. And I'll just go over the agenda so we know what we will walk away with after today's meeting. We'll begin with introductions and icebreakers so you can meet all of us. We'll move into community standards so we can orient ourselves in this space. January is National Mentoring Month, which is why we are all gathered here today, and we will get a chance to learn about all that entails. Then we have some announcements for you all, what we have coming up in National Mentoring Month, and then we'll get to hear from you all what you all have in January and 2024 at large, as well as what you all have done in years past. And then we will finish up with some resources so you can walk out of here with something in hand. So we'll jump right in and start off with introductions and icebreakers. So I'll pass it to Laura Green, our executive director.
I'm trying to get on camera. Okay. Hey, good morning, everybody. Good morning. Laura Green, executive director of Mentor Maryland, DC. Super thrilled to be in this space with you all today. We have a lot of great information about National Mentoring Month. With that, I'll kick it right on to Renee.
Hey everybody, Renee Angelamock, she, they pronouns, operations manager here at Mentor Maryland DC. Happy to be here with you. I'm going to introduce my colleague Dakota, who's not here with us today, program outreach associate. You likely remember her because she has returned to us this past year. She was a VISTA long ago, and she's back with our family. So you will see her throughout National Mentoring Month as well. But I'm going to kick it now to Kiana.
Hey, y'all. I'm Kiana Bermudez. I am the Program Outreach and Support Manager for the Greater Maryland Region. So most of y'all who are in Maryland, I am your go-to gal. I'm really glad you're here, really glad to connect, and excited to share some good info with y'all. Dayon, kick it over to you. Dayon is my partner in crime here.
Yeah. Thanks, KB. Partner in crime. I love it. So my name is Dayon McLaurin Johnson, and I am also the Program Outreach Support Manager. I'm responsible for, well, I'm not responsible. That's maybe a strong word, but I help the programs that are in Prince George's, Montgomery, the District of Columbia, and kind of slipping into Northern Virginia too. Y'all keep that quiet. We're having a good time. I want to introduce also my colleague who is not on the call, who you'll see from the DMV, Andrew Lolivar. Y'all, he just completed his MBA. So excited about that, brother. And most of y'all have been have interacted with Andrew. He's helping his baby sister move back from college, who also graduated from undergrad. So he's packing a U-Haul right now as we speak. So y'all give a shout out to Andrew when you see him. I'm going to kick it next to my colleague, Andre Forrester.
Hi, everybody. My name is Andre Forrester, as Dayon just said. I'm the Marketing and Communications Associate here at Mentor Maryland, DC. So I run a lot of our social media. I help publish our newsletters. I work on the Mentor Maryland, DC website. If you ever need to contact us through social media, I'm probably the person you're talking to. It's great to meet you all. We have a wonderful presentation for you guys today, and I'm going to pass it over to Rebecca.
Hi again. My name is Rebecca Shipman. I am the Workplace Mentoring VISTA. I use she, her pronouns, and I will kick it to my fellow VISTA, Jeff.
Get it again. I'm Jeff Kearney, the External Affairs VISTA. I do outreach to government officials and agencies and other non-affiliated stakeholders like corporations. I'm a former attorney. My first year doing Capitol Hill Day Looking forward to it, and definitely good to see you all, some of you again. And I'll send it back to Laura.
All right, yeah, I can take it from here. So that was our team. As Dayan said, we have a full team today, so you're going to hear from a lot of us here. But just to help ground us a bit, for those of y'all who may not be fully familiar with us, we are Mentor Maryland DC. We have a national organization. So they create all these wonderful bodies of work, and then we help distribute that to our local affiliate. So we are the local affiliate. We are your go-tos when it comes to Maryland and DC. We are a nonpartisan organization, and our big goal is to ensure that we can ensure that young people, we're increasing mentoring across Maryland and DC for young people, increasing the quality and the quantity of that. So we want to make sure that we're increasing those relationships for young people. And we do that through providing research, providing trainings, public awareness, making sure that y'all have the resources you need to do that. So we do that through different events like this, our roundtables. We host trainings virtually, in person. And we really just want to make sure that y'all have the resources to ensure that mentoring is happening across the board. But we'd love to learn a little bit more about y'all and who's in the room. So I'll pass it to Rebecca for a little icebreaker.
So I do have the joy of doing the icebreaker during this meeting. And our question is, as we move into the winter season, what are your favorite seasonal foods? And Dayan will launch a little quiz.
Did y'all get it?
And we can
come
all...
on. Oh, this is the first time I've launched the poll ever. Come on. This is exciting.
You can pick more than one.
Oh, look. Come on, somebody knows they want to put fruitcake. I don't know why y'all tripping. Come on. What's a pizzelle? What is that?
Pizzelle. It's a pressed Italian cookie. Yeah, it's Italian. Looks like what like a waffle cone is made out of. It's like if a waffle cone was like pressed out, it's a pressed cookie.
So you're bringing those to the office? Is that what you're telling us?
It's flavored typically. Sure. I'll source some good ones. I'll have to go to Little Italy.
Eggnog. Look, eggnog is in front. All right, we're almost, let's see. We got about 3 or 4 more people that need to put their 2 cents in. Come on.
We can't see the results. Can you share the results?
We have to read them.
No, I can't show the results until everybody votes.
It's neat. Oh, okay.
Everybody has to vote. All right. I need 2 more people. Oh, okay. No, Jasmine's driving. Okay. All right. Here we go. Y'all ready? What do y'all think's in the lead?
I'm hoping it's eggnog.
Eggnog is not it.
Okay. Did y'all see the results? Can y'all see it?
No.
No? Okay. What do I have to do now, Laura? Oh, Renee, I got to share them. Okay.
Yeah, sure. There you go.
Oh, we see it.
Can y'all see it now?
Cookies, yes.
Eggnog was second.
It's just cream and sugar. You can't go wrong with that.
Wait, hold on. What else? Creamy. I didn't see. I didn't slide all the way down. All I saw was eggnog was at the bottom. I didn't see all the ones under that. Christmas cookies. Okay, so the next... Obviously, the next question is going to be like, okay, what type of Christmas cookie? But that'll be, hey, put that in the chat, y'all. What type of Christmas cookie? Put that in the chat, all right? And we're ready to keep it moving. All right, let's see. Put your favorite Christmas cookie in the chat, and we will go on to our next slide. Thank y'all for participating. Chocolate chip, that's what I'm saying right there.
All right. So while y'all are exploring those cookie options, just want to ground us in some community standards we have. So this is something we do at the beginning of all of our trainings and meetings. And just to make sure that we are all on the same page about how we want to approach this space. So I'll quickly go through these and we'll make sure we all agree on them. So the first is that our community is open to all. We also want to acknowledge that there is deep-seated racism, sexism, homo and transphobia, misogyny, ableism that's pervasive in our country. We want to make sure that we share that we are against these isms and actively work to the same, especially when working with our young people. Excuse me. Renee, would you be able to jump in real quick?
Yeah, let's see. Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
Okay, all right. I didn't hear where you were, KB, but be generous with positive
Sorry,
assumptions.
Just coughing attack. I was on the second one. I can jump back in. Sorry about that. So we just want to make sure that we understand that we all approach our work beautifully and differently, and we all approach this with a different bias. In a space, we want to make sure we're sharing openly, but important to that we're even listening more openly. And so being open to when you're sharing might hurt, understanding that your aha moment and your that's really cool moment might be a ouch, that kind of hurt moment, and being open to approaching that with questions and just trying to wonder in those moments. Being generous with positive assumptions, so not being afraid to ask genuine questions when you're unsure why something might have been asked or said or approached. And then this is one of my favorites. No matter what your role is here today, you're a host. So in this space, we all have the ability to make this as fun as we want and as engaging as we want, and understanding that while we're facilitating this, we are all hosts in this space and we all have a role here to play. We don't endeavor to create a safe or comfortable space, but rather a brave space where we can explore that discomfort and beliefs and practices can be challenged. We also want this community and experience to be supportive and educational, but most importantly, fun. So we will talk about cookies. We will talk about eggnog. We will talk about silly things, but please make sure that you're bringing your full and present self. It is welcome here. We just want to make sure this is a good time where we can all connect. And last but not least, no fixing, saving, advising, or correcting each other. So making sure that we are all, again, going back to those positive assumptions. If you feel that anyone is not holding to these standards, just let one of the many staff members here know. We want to make sure this is a good space and brave space for all of us. But if you have any questions about that, feel free to reach out to us. And you can also DM us individually if any of you have anything regarding this or any other questions throughout our time together.
January is National Mentoring Month, but what is National Mentoring Month? It was established in 2002 and recognized yearly by the U.S. President and administration. National Mentoring Month is a time to celebrate the power of mentoring and encourage others to explore how mentoring programs can enable organizations and communities to create more productive, engaged, and satisfied people.
So what are our goals? I'm not going to read all of these bullets on the slide because I know you good folks can do that. But I more so want to just encapsulate what the spirit of all of this means. And I think that it really boils down to three main goals. We want to raise awareness of all the different types of mentoring that's going on in the landscape. That's why all of you beautiful people are here. We want to inspire more people to become mentors, to support mentoring programs, to just uplift and talk about the transformative power of relationships. And lastly, we want to celebrate you all. We want to ignite, celebrate all of the work and uplift all of the work that all of you all do. So through all of these bullet points here, we aim to achieve all of that. And with that, I think we'll go into the next slide. We want to have a little more interaction. Look at this wonderful photo. Dayon, did you want to voice over this photo real quick before we get into our next group activity?
Yeah, and Laura, I don't think we've done this, Laura, but we want to recognize you as our new executive director. Have y'all, Laura, all of y'all that are on this call? See, Laura, come on.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yes, I am about 95 days, 3 hours and 19 minutes in to being the new executive director of Mentor Maryland, DC. I joke and I say I am a recovering executive director of a direct service mentoring org. I was the founding ED of iMentor Baltimore, which is also part of a regional national model. And so I know this work well. A little bit about my personal story is I was born into the DC foster care system. I was adopted as a baby. So the first transformative relationship in my life were my parents. So this work is personal to me, and as I'm sure it is to all of you all, and I couldn't be more thrilled to sit at the helm of an organization that just helps uplift and empower all of the great mentoring work that's being done around the DMV. So that's why I'm here, and that's what I'm for. And please, call on us and call on me anytime. So thank you, Dayon, for that. Thank you so much. But I want to hear more about what really got you all excited last year. I wasn't here on this side of the work last year, and National Mentoring Month was a wonderful time for several of you in this space. And so I think with the next slide, we have a little question. We want to take the next five to 10 minutes, and we want folks to share out what inspired you the most from previous National Mentor Month events. And because I like to go in with the deck loaded, isn't that what they say? I'm going to call on Dayon to kick this conversation off while everyone is processing real time and transporting themselves back to last year around this time. Perhaps you did Capitol Hill Day. Perhaps you were part of the summit. Perhaps it was MLK Day. Or perhaps you just did something that you never had the chance to share with anybody else about back in January of last year. And now's your chance. But to kick us off, Dayon, what was something that inspired you the most from previous National Mentor Month activities? And you got to come off mute. It felt real inspiring, though.
I was going in, Laura. I had already finished half of what I was going to say. So last year, I think what stuck out for me was going to all the multiple jurisdictions, driving over to the Eastern Shore, going to Western Maryland for these proclamations. And so in this particular picture, this is Montgomery County's version. We've got the council members, we've got our program partners, we've got the county executive in this picture. And this is really an acknowledgement of, you know, National Mentoring Month being January, but I think more importantly, it elevates the programs that are doing the work in Montgomery County. And so that happens regionally. And we've already sent out the request for proclamations for all of the jurisdictions in Maryland and in DC. And so we're looking forward. I think that's what stuck out for me, Laura, most about last month. And there were a lot of last January, a lot of things stuck out, but this one really was cool, getting to see all of the different people all across the state. So I'll stop there. Anybody else love to share, or what stuck out for you last year in our National Mentoring Month celebrations?
I'll hop in. Hello, everyone. My name is Diamond Bell, and I'm from Spark the Journey. Unfortunately, last year, I did not go to the summit because things were a bit busy at our organization, but we hosted our annual mentor brunch, and that's something I look forward to every January. It's bottomless mimosas. We get a caterer. We invite our mentors. If you guys are interested, I'll put it in the chat. You guys can join us. It's the same week as the mentor summit this year. It's that Saturday. So if you guys want to end off the conference, hanging out with Spark the Journey, you guys can join us.
You said bottomless? Wait. Yes.
It's a fun time.
Who else? Who else like to share? Tracy, you know we got to do that in Baltimore.
I know.
I can hop in. Sorry that I'm not on camera. I'm a little under the weather today, so I just am hiding a little bit. But I don't remember necessarily if this was during January, but I know something that really inspired a lot of us at Collegiate Directions was the summit that you all had that was like student-based, and we had a bunch of our students be a part of it. I think that was huge because we got to be front and center seeing our kids flourish. So that was definitely very, very inspiring.
Thank you, Claire. Hope you feel better.
Thank you.
Yeah. Good. Let's do one more.
Similar to us, like similar on Spark the Journey. Here at Best Kids, we do our annual mentor appreciation event where we call it the Besties. And it's pretty similar. It's like the Emmys and, you know, Grammys, because it's like award season. And so we give out like just recognition to all of the mentors who have contributed to the program over the year. And then we also show like our match of the year video that we allow our mentor of the mentor of the year just to highlight their work and you know, their contribution to the program. The person that we selected this year has been in our program for like 7 years, and her mentee has done like an amazing job navigating the foster care system. And she's got accepted to like 4 different colleges, and she got accepted to my alma mater, Savannah State. So I'm like, I'm hype about that. So it's just like a dope thing that we're gonna be able to display this year. So that's coming up, January 19th. So y'all are all invited to.
The Besties, I love that. I love that. Hey y'all, show some love in the chat for Collegiate Directions and Best Kids and Spark the Journey. They're doing amazing work in our region. We'll go to
one, even though I work here.
Go ahead, Rick.
I mean, not to hype ourselves, but I love our MLK contest. Having been here, now done 2 or 3, and have just been on the other side. But last year, we specifically focused on MLK as a mentor and a mentee, which was really cool to learn about. I mean, we were learning about it because we were like, who was MLK mentors? Like, we didn't know until we set it up. And it was really fun. The celebration was really fun. We had a youth poet perform and the kids were really into it. Parents always come and the winners are always really excited, and their parents are as well. So it was really fun. And then I also want to shout out that one of the mentors that we highlighted of MLK was Bayard Rustin, who now there's a Netflix movie about him. So it feels like that movie was created because of us, probably.
Cool.
So then this is a hint that you should also participate in this year's MLK event. We'll talk about it in a little bit. But yeah, it was really exciting and I loved it. That's it.
Good job. Thanks, Renee. Anybody else? All right. We will break off now into what's happening for National Mentoring Month next month. And we're going to kick off to our resident marketing guru. Can y'all show Andre some love in the chat? He is, you guys are very familiar with his work.
You're looking at
hi again, everybody. As Renee was just saying, yes, the Martin Luther King Mentoring Challenge is coming up. And we just wanted to let you guys know that this is going to be our 4th annual one. And this contest is an opportunity for young people and their mentors to think about how mentoring impacts them, their communities, and how it's impacted inspiring figures like Martin Luther King Jr. This challenge is for young people in 6th through 12th grade to compete with their mentors. And if a young person doesn't have a mentor, they can answer based on an adult who inspires them. And we just want you to know the deadline for submission will be January 8th. And then we will host an award ceremony on January 15th, which would be Martin Luther King Day. And then join us again on January 9th at 12:30 to attend the Adopting a Mentoring Mindset training. The mentoring mindset includes the essential attitudes, values, or philosophy with which people approach their role in mentoring. This mentoring mindset goes beyond simply creating a culture that fosters mentor relationships, but also structures mentoring in a helpful way, including behaviors such as being constructive, respecting difference and diversity, and cultivating positive progress. If you know someone who's considering mentoring or people that want to get better with mentoring, just make sure they can join us for the workshop to ensure that their mindset is ready. And also at the bottom, I've listed some roundtables that we have coming up. So if you are in Baltimore City or Anne Arundel County, make sure you join us for those as well.
Good job, Andre. Come on now. All right. Hey, Renee, what's this stuff about?
Cool. So here at Mentor Morale DC, we are relaunching our efforts in Connect, Focus, Grow, which is a a nationally researched and a based curriculum that our affiliates and our friend Mentor National implement. And it is about equipping mentors and supervisors in the workplace and mentees and their young people on how we can ensure that in the workplace there are relationships that can make the workplace experience better for everyone. And I know across Maryland and DC, workforce development is at the top of people's minds as we want to prepare young people to, you know, graduate from high school and to be ready for the workforce. And that, you know, some young people are already out there and working. So this is an opportunity for programs, businesses, corporations, employers, anybody that cares about the success of young people in the workplace or runs a workplace to come and learn more about this Connect, Focus, Grow curriculum and process. So come and learn about it so we can tell you about it because it is so very special. So there's just an info session just to learn about it. And that is Thursday, January 18th. And we look forward to seeing you there. And then somebody mentioned the summit. This happens every January, put up by our friends at Mentor National. It is a very exciting time. You can still register. A free part of the summit is Capitol Hill Day, which Jeff was referring to earlier. This is a time to come to Capitol Hill, Washington, D.C., and our friends at Mentor National will help us set up meetings with all of our representatives. So anybody across Maryland, you'll be meeting with your representative on Capitol Hill to talk about the bills and legislation that have to do with, you know, affecting our youth and affecting mentoring, right? It's things like, what am I saying? Funding, things that we care about, right? So you'll be able to make that face-to-face contact with them and advocate on behalf of your young people and your programs. And one of the things that's really great about that is they also train us on how to do that, how to do it well, and how to make the most of those meetings in that time. So Capitol Hill Day is Wednesday. You can still register now. Registration is limited. So if you do want to participate in Capitol Hill Day, you should register like literally right now because registration is limited. But that is on Wednesday of that last week of January. And then the summit is the latter half of that week. This is a paid event. But this is the largest convening of mentoring practitioners from across the United States. There'll be representatives from all of the affiliates across the United States. So our friends from Mentor California, Mentor Washington, Mentor Texas, Mentor Georgia will all be there. A bunch of them are putting on the workshops. I'm planning on a workshop. You should come to my workshop. You should come to any workshops. There's lots of great workshops there on lots of topics that are relevant to you in the mentoring field. And this is the time to also hear about what's coming in the mentoring field, right? You know, what are the pressing issues? So time to connect with like-minded professionals, and it's in DC. So for a lot of us, that'll be, you know, commutable and things like that. So you'll be able to register. Registration should be open up until the summit. I hope it doesn't sell out so you can register. So register now if you can. And all of Mentor Maryland DC team will be there. And that Thursday we will be hosting during lunchtime. We'll be having our own little summit mixer during lunch. So come join us the summit will tell you what room we'll be in, but we'll be there hosting a little lunch networking event. And so if you're at the summit, we will definitely see you. It'll be hard for you not to see us. We'll be there. So we really hope that you will join us there.
Cool. Thank you, Renee. Tracy, we'll post that link in the chat. Notice Renee mentioned that mixer. Unfortunately, unlike Spark the Journey, I don't foresee us having bottomless mimosas. But if you're in DC, please join us. And before we jump into this, the next segment, I just want most of you know we do have some new colleagues from Mentor Maryland DC on our call. And we've got just gurus in the house. So you just heard from Renee. She's our training guru. If any of your programs need training, she's the person on our staff to really reach out to. Incredibly insightful and tapped into mentoring all across the globe. Secondly, we've got Rebecca. Rebecca, can you just kind of raise your hand? Rebecca joined our team. She's our workforce development guru. So any of your programs that are interested in workforce development or expanding your reach into the private sector, Rebecca is on our team and she's the one that's leading that charge. Now, Jeff, can you wave your hand like you don't just don't care? Y'all, Jeff is our external affairs VISTA. So Jeff does all of our correspondence reaching out to politicians, reaching out to government officials, reaching out to private sector corporations. If your organization needs help in that endeavor, Jeff is the man. And y'all heard his voice. He kind of like really has one of those politician voices almost. So he's perfect for this position. And then last but not least, y'all heard from our marketing specialist, Andre Forrester. Andre, really all of the graphics, all of the PowerPoint slides, all the stuff, he does that for us internally, but externally, he also puts out our newsletter. And if your organization has anything that you want to announce and send out across our network, reach out to Andre. He'll put his email in the chat so you have his information. Anything that you want sent out, even mentor recruitment, even positions that your organization may have open and you're trying to hire someone, send those to Andre and Andre will get those out. So that's our team, not to mention our fearless leader, Laura Green, who we're so excited to be our new executive director, and my partner in crime, KB, Kiana Bermudez. So that's our team, and we're excited that you're with us today. We're going to go to our next portion. And Renee, if you want to, can you share a little bit about these program partner highlights? I think you're on this one.
Yes. So this is a bit of a teaser as there's more information coming, but for our friends on this call, we want to formalize our partnership with you. We want to make it official. So we are going to, in January, formalize that partnership by naming what our partnership is with you all and with our larger partners as well, not just programs, right? So we're going to be giving those names to those partnerships. We're going to be connecting with you about what it means to be each type of partner, which I'll go over in just a second, and really bonding that by giving you these little badges that you see on the screen and by highlighting what it means on our website. So we're going to have our program partners who are partners who are live in the mentoring connector, who meet those minimum quality standards for what it means to be a mentoring program. Of our NQMS partners who are programs who have been through the National Quality Mentoring System, which is also something you can still do. You can always do through our quality assistance. So reach out if you want to learn more about that. Our Relationship Center Schools partners, which will be school-based programs, school districts who have worked with us to apply Relationship Centered Schools foundations into their either school-based program or district. And then I mentioned before, Connect, Focus, Grow. We're looking for our Connect, Focus, Grow partners out there as we're just kind of relaunching this effort here at Mentor Maryland DC. But our Connect, Focus, Grow partners will be those who go through the Connect, Focus, Grow curriculum with us. It's that powerful that you're going to be able to get to be highlighted on our website. So in January, you'll be able to read more about what each of these means, and we'll be in touch with you, our programs, sooner than later, about specifically program partnerships soon. So this is just a teaser. This more information about this is forthcoming, and it is very exciting. And my dog is barking, so I'll be right back.
Thanks, Renee. Thank you. Now, we've got to cover a lot and what we've got happening coming up in January. The next thing we want to do as a call is to find out, and some of you mentioned it, but do you have anything that you would like to share out with everybody that's on the call that your organization has going on for January? Or even if you have a program that you think you might need assistance from our team, please feel free to share that out. Feel free to come off mute and share. We've got time to discuss.
Well, hi. My name is,
Tracy.
My name is Tracy Cheek. I'm with Elevate Baltimore. We are very excited to be launching kind of what we do in mentoring. And I'm currently working with you guys with technical assistance, and we're really looking to expand and scale what we do. We do a lot of crossover around workforce development. That's another focus of ours. So I think what we're doing with mentoring is going to grow, and I'd like to continue to grow with you guys, but I'm going to need some support. So as a former practitioner of the work. My goal is to try to build this out in a way that makes the most sense. We support about 21 different community schools. We have an adult high school, so we have a lot of different touch points and opportunities for mentoring and different types of mentoring. So I am excited to try to bring whatever opportunities or partnerships we can do to my executive director as we plan around our funding as well. So
beautiful. Tracy, y'all are doing amazing work. So thank y'all. Hey, y'all give it up for Tracy at Elevate Baltimore. Thank you.
So open to partner with anyone like-minded and be a thought partner or even partner officially as an organization.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Yolanda, I saw that you were also coming off mute. Yolanda Nelson, what you got going on?
Hi, I'm Yolanda Nelson with the Cute Girl Club Mentoring Program. We are having a holiday tour. Yeah, actually, it started in November. We have supporters, Victoria's Secret, along with I Support the Girls, and we've been going to different schools, H.D. Woodson High School. We'll be at Largo on Friday, distributing feminine products, bras, panties, a whole host of coats. I'm having a coat drive. We're giving out probably about 100 coats. So we're trying to get our ladies ready for the wintertime. And the funding is kind of low for us, but I'm the executive director and I've really been coming out of my pocket, but I'm excited to be a part of this mentor, DC, Maryland.
Yolanda, thank you. Thank you for your heart for the work and keep up the good work. And we'll continue to be connecting. And so we don't want you to keep coming out of pocket. We want to support you and make sure that you are ready to go. But keep up the great work.
Can I comment Largo. On that?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yolanda, I just put in the chat, the Baltimore Community Foundation has a mitzvah grant. Mitzvah is Yiddish for good deeds. These are small grants that are $10,000 or less. And I think your project could be a good mitzvah. Any of you are welcome to click on that link, but check that out as in the application is really easy.
I thank you so much for that information. Thank you.
Good. Anyone else want to share out? I think Diamond, did you? I thought you came off mute. Okay.
I didn't, but I can share something. Okay. Next year, we're launching our LMS system. So that'll be excited. We don't have to have tons of trainings throughout the year. We'll limit some of our trainings to do some in-person and virtual. At the beginning of the new year, we'll start recruiting for our high school team again, as well as preparing for our year up partnership. At Spark the Journey, we work with high school students, post-secondary students, and young professionals in year up. So that'll be our first matching cycle to get those students 18 to 30 with a mentor and an internship.
Beautiful. Is that LMS going to be just in-house or will it be open to other partners?
No, just in-house first. Hopefully it'll come something bigger over the next couple of years, but we're just trying to test it out. Because honestly, guys, we probably host like 30 trainings a year. And I'm the face of all the training. So I'll be excited to have some free time back and not host right. them all.
No, that's right. All right. And Rebecca, you got to make the connection with Diamond. I don't know if we've met, if you've met Diamond yet, but yeah, we'll definitely connect you too. Anyone else like to share out?
Hi. One of the things that we're working on, I'm Patricia, and I run the Styles Girls Mentoring Program in Montgomery County. And so next year we're working on, and the Styles is Stylish Thriving Young Ladies Embracing Success. And our program is around young ladies that are interested in the beauty industry, fashion, and we now have added like a STEM program part of it, creating products so they can have their own income, self-sufficient. And so we're looking for an alternative space for 2024 for young ladies that almost like an alternative school with a component of apprenticeship program of them being able to become a licensed cosmetologist. So that's what we're looking to do for 2024.
If anyone has, thank you, Patricia. You're an amazing asset to that Montgomery County community. And I know you were talking about expanding even to Northern Virginia and over to Prince George's. Everybody that's on the call, y'all keep an eye out for Patricia. And we'll share out the notes if any of you have any additional questions about the other people that are on the call. We've got time for two more share outs, and then we're going to share just a couple of more resources that we have for National Mentoring Month.
I'd like to share. My name is Aniola Osamu, and I'm the outreach director here at Court Appointed Special Advocates. And we're just excited that we are recent grant recipients for the Guaranteed Basic Income Thrive Program. That's a public-private partnership between the state of Maryland, Prince George's County, and the Community Foundation. And what that grant allows us to do is to find, I believe, 50 recently emancipated prior foster care youth, which is the main population that we serve here at CASA, to receive $800, no strings attached, money every single month for the next 24 months, along with 60 seniors who will also receive the same amount. So we're really excited that we are the recipients of this grant. And court-appointed special advocates, we recruit, we train everyday people to become volunteers, to be best interest advocates for children and youth that are experiencing foster care. So of course, our main population are foster care youth in Prince George's County. Over 70% of youth experiencing foster care are close to emancipation. So we're really excited that we're able to provide this level of, again, no strings attached financial support for our youth, many of them who are parents themselves. So we're really excited. This program launches in January, and we are deep in sort of building the programmatic capabilities to be able to actually operationalize it, because it's a big undertaking. We're really excited about that. And we're always looking to recruit more people to become volunteers for our organization.
Beautiful. Adiola, let's definitely connect. That is an amazing initiative. So please, let's connect and see how we can help support you guys you're launching in January. Is that what you stated?
Yes. The grant launches in January.
Okay. Okay. Yep. Thank you. Great. Great. All right. Well, team, we want to share out just a couple of things in preparation for January. And this is a toolkit that your organization can utilize during the month of January to reach out to more constituents. And so as you see, and we'll share this link to this toolkit for you, and it came from our national office, but it's got logos, it's got digital engagement, how to post in your social media accounts. It talks about how to reach out to your politicians, all of those different constituents and stakeholders that your organization needs to connect with. This toolkit will help your organization reach out during the month of January. And I'm thinking about you, Adiola, especially with those Prince George County officials, making sure that your program is not only elevated, but we can really elevate it during January and National Mentoring Month. So I believe that my colleagues are going to put that in the chat, that toolkit. If you have any questions on how to utilize that toolkit, once again, remember, our staff is full. We've got marketing, we've got external affairs, we've got workforce development, we've got regional managers to assist your programs during the month of January. Claire, I just wanted to highlight Claire's note in the chat. So if y'all could look at the chat, I'm just going to read that real quick, Claire, if you don't mind. I know that you're not feeling well. Claire is with Collegiate Directions. Our school support program is really expanding our public events during the next couple of months and weeks. And in January, the programming will be focused on financial aid due to all the changes in FAFSA. Ooh, I didn't know about that, Claire. So I need to check that. My goodness, FAFSA. I believe the events on the website update every month. Claire, thank you for dropping that in. If you, anyone else has anything that they want to add, please drop that in the chat. Claire, that's important because, ooh, my 23-year-old is wearing me out with this FAFSA. I'm telling you, all right? All right, so we're going to go ahead and share with you our last slide is what does our support look like? And I think my colleague KB is going to cover this slide. What you got, KB?
Absolutely. So y'all know our literal goal is just to make sure y'all have everything you need and all the resources you need. So we have a bunch of resources. As Dayan said, we'll share these slides out. So all of these links are clickable. I just want to highlight a few. So we have technical assistance and consultation that we do at no cost. And that a lot of y'all who are on this call, I think a few, I know Tracy, you mentioned that you're currently in talking to us right now. There's a few of you who have also taken advantage of technical assistance and consultation. So it's a great resource. We can support with anything from creating mentor recruitment plans to logic models to anything from like beginning a mentoring program to strengthening it to whatever that may look like. And we have a whole cadre of expert consultants, and we do our best to match you with a consultant who's an expert in your specific area, the specific niche, and in your geographic location. So it's a great opportunity there. We also have all sorts of events from regional roundtables where y'all have gotten to meet myself and Dayan at a few of those. We have trainings that we do, such as the Adopting a Better Mindset one that we highlighted. We do those monthly. We do a mixture of virtual and in-person. So please make sure you're staying connected to us there. We'd love to make sure that y'all are getting the resources you need and that we can support in whatever way we can. And last but not least, our Elements of Effective Practice is our biggest body of work. And it outlines all the benchmarks and standards that a mentoring program and the standards that a mentoring program should hold to. So I'm going to pass it over to Rebecca to go a little bit more into some additional tools, especially with that Elements of Effective Practice.
Yeah, as Kiana just let you know, the Elements of Effective Practice is really a comprehensive guide that takes you through the six stages of a really healthy mentoring relationship, which translates into strength and length of the relationship. We love it when things rhyme like that. Makes it easy on all of us. And then on the right-hand side of your screen, we have what can look like a pretty overwhelming list of resources, and we have even more via our website. So I'd really encourage you to look at this list with a discerning eye. You are all serving individual people with individual needs. And if you can just pick out one of these resources that most fits the population you're serving, you can really zero in on something that will be helpful. But I will take this time to raise up that last bullet point, becoming a better mentor guide. And I think a lot of people on this call are already utilizing this mentoring mindset. And we understand the value, the joy, and the excitement of the ability and the opportunity to become better. So I would really encourage you to use becoming a better mentor guide, that being it's applicable to everyone on this call. We are all striving for that as a jumping off point into these resources. And then I will turn it back over to Dayan.
Beautiful. We've got a couple of seconds. Anyone have any questions that they need to have answered? I'm going to also, well, KB, can we drop in? If you want to meet, if you're in my region or if you're in KB's region and you want to schedule a 15, 30 minute hour session, we're going to put or a meeting, or just you want to choose some ideas as far as National Mentoring Month. We're going to y'all look in the chat what Renee just put. She, oh my goodness. All right. So that's a whole nother conversation. But if you would like to schedule a consultation or a chat with Renee and I, we'll put our Calendly links in the chat. Renee just did it. And Renee, where is Butterbeans? Can Butterbeans close us out? I know y'all think we don't really.
I don't know. I got to go check. I'll be right back.
Well, Butterbeans is our staff member that we did not mention. That is Renee's dog. Butterbeans wishes all of you a happy holiday season. And hopefully we will see you in National Mentoring Month. If y'all have any questions or need any support, please don't hesitate. Y'all show some love in the chat. I hope that y'all have a great, safe time over the next several weeks. Thank y'all. So, oh, wait, Laura, what's yours? Who it? Oh, my goodness.
Rotten. This is Lucy. Rotten. Lucy, if he has her Christmas scarf on, she's feeling real special.
Oh, my goodness.
She's feeling herself.
Just so you know, I'm scheduling with everybody. So I'm just going to schedule to talk to all of you.
Do it. That's what we want.
I have a lot to talk about the mentoring.
But
we're very interested in this being one of our key services we provide as an organization. So I'm very excited.
Tracy, you're doing great work. Yeah. So
I'm trying to make it happen and bringing a mental health layer in as well. This year, in terms of getting a lot of the team trained in first aid so that we can kind of triage and do those things. So, yes, definitely we're going to be talking. So,
awesome.
Thank you, guys.
Awesome. Yeah, we'll hang out here for a little bit if anyone has any questions too. But.
Public service announcement, go see Origin, the movie.
Ooh.
I saw a sneak preview of it yesterday. And it's powerful. It's changing how I'm framing conversations around race, oppression, and power. And yeah. I never thought that anything could be a deposit that would challenge my thinking into that. But it is powerful. And yes, it connects to India. It connects to Germany. And it connects to us in America. And it's just an incredible, the movie is a narrative work, but it's actually a thesis statement come to life by a African-American Pulitzer Prize author. So check it out. It is powerful. And my nephew plays Trayvon Martin. So.
Hey, that was the best plug I've heard.
Yeah, that was a great song.
I'm sold.
And the filmmaker, Ava DuVernay, is looking to get as many 14, 15, and 16-year-olds to see the movie as possible. So I think, you know, in regard to our work with young people, it's compelling to get them to see this film. Wait, hold on. I might have taken a note of her nonprofit that gives tickets for this. See, it was meant for me. Seat 16. Maybe it's seat, SEAT16.org, maybe. I didn't catch the rest of it. But if you Google Ava DuVernay and Seat 16, you can see a way. They're giving away crazy tickets, or maybe you buy one ticket and you get 40. I don't know how it works. But it's a push. And she definitely wants as many 14, 15, and 16-year-olds as possible to see it. And I'm telling you, this ain't in the history books yet. So it's amazing.
That's awesome.
Thank you for sharing that, Laura.
Patricia, I didn't hear you. I think you're on mute. I know you said something.
All right. What's the name of the movie again?
Origin.
Oh, okay.
And it's off of Isabella, I can't think of her last name, the Pulitzer Prize winner writer, but she wrote this book called Cast, The Origins of Our Descent. And
I was wondering if it was based off of Cast. Okay, so this is the adaptation of Cast. Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay, I'm going to check it out. That book is very good, too.
It's amazing. Yeah. Life-changing, at least for me. Yeah.
The Cast articulates it in a way that most people have not heard it before. And I think that's more pivotal than arguing over CRT. So that's good. I'm going to check it out.
Good. Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. Just want to give a quick acknowledgement. Rebecca Singavong from Latinas Leading Tomorrow just joined in. Just want to give you a shout out, Rebecca. We will definitely give you the recording and we'll also put the chat. I know you asked about putting that in the chat. Hey, thank you for representing.
Thank you. Sorry, I got pulled into a meeting.
That's okay. Hey, keep up the great work, okay? All right, awesome. All right, everyone.
Bye. Any questions, lingering questions, needs? We're around.
We'll stay on. But don't feel obligated. We'll stay on, though. Good job, Yolanda.
Awesome. So you did record it, so that's good.
Yeah, we got you.
And you share with me.
Yeah, we'll share. I'll send it out to you, Rebecca.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. As well.
Good. Good. What'd you say, Renee? Okay.
I'm going to save the chat.
Okay. Okay, you got it. Okay. So I don't have to hit any buttons. You got it, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Woo.
Right.
All right.
Bye, guys.
See ya.